That's not just the scene growing. The funny thing is that the one guy that used to live there actually moved away. So he's not part of the scene. It's like, it's like, man, there's no Smashers here. I'm going to move. And then a new scene just spawns. Oh, my God. We were talking about this.
Yeah, exactly.
We were talking about this. And again, big risk.
If I was the people at home right now, I would be changing my bets right
now. Yeah, me too.
I would be changing my
bets. You just said you don't want to be down two or three stocks in the beginning. And this matchup is one of the hardest, most brutal matchups
in Smash.
In Smash. As far as good characters go.
Exactly.
This is...
I don't think a blind pick for Team England could have gone any better than this right now.
No way. I can't believe we're talking about this. Like, and it happens. I don't think it's a good pick, but it is risky. Yeah, it is.
He went straight in, and he's got the Peach. Do you know how well he does against Peach normally? I mean, I haven't seen too much...
No, I don't know. Do they have Blaze in Germany?
Yes.
So
I played him earlier. He's really good.
He's really good. Yeah. Okay. So he's got some experience at least. And I think, I mean, most ice climbers, many of them at least, kind of wanna be the ice climber that proves that the matchup isn't that bad, you know?
Yeah.
So most of them really try to learn the matchup and really try to figure something out. So it's very common to see that you have ice climbers versus Peach and the ice climbers win because they have really put work into the matchup, whereas the Peach goes in with the bad mindset of, this is a great matchup, I'm going to win. But hey, man, it's Ice Climbers. One grab. Like, there's no DI factors. There's no edge guarding. There's nothing that they can mess up on the road to victory. And oh, my God, it starts out with a
shield
break. I can't believe that.
That set the tone.
Nana's dead. Yeah. VA knows this matchup. He's Alpha Dash, I would guess.
Yeah.
Do they play a lot?
They must have played quite a few times. I would assume definitely in tournaments because they're both very good players. They don't live very close to each other.
Okay. But
you would expect VA to know this matchup.
Like. Yeah. Yeah. And I mean that kill that he got there. Ooh, very nice. Kills him with up smash. Doimling, looking a bit concerned actually. It's like he's kind of I would be as well. This is bad, man. And VA is good in cruise. He showed that yesterday.
Yep.
Versus Spain. Ooh, oh my God, he got the grab and then the crouch cancel on the down smash. 58% and a mistake with the down throw.
Down smash too good. Yeah. He just did it twice and then boom, 58%.
Yep.
All right.
Oh no, he had the grab, but then he becomes ice, which is, it's percent dependent, so it's not random, but it's not something he was expecting, so. It was unfortunate.
I like how VA splitting him up. Sometimes he's not going after Nana, but he did that time.
Yeah. It can be risky to go to get tunnel vision on Nana, you know?
Yeah.
Because that many Ice Climbers players actually use that to bait their opponents off stage and go for an edge guard.
Yeah.
And now, again, we got VA with a commanding lead.
His two stock right now is looking kind of healthy. Kind of nice.
Yeah. But if he gets this stock quick, this could turn around completely because, you know, Ice Climbers get one smash attack and then one grab and then it's completely even.
And their smashes are so quick and they hit so hard.
Yeah.
All right, can he get this edge guard?
Oh my God. Oh.
That's the jab.
Oh, we almost had the hedgehog. Okay, gets the trade. That's a good trade. He wants this and now he's going to be fishing for the grab. But Nani's off stage, gets back here and she's dead.
Nana's
she's
gone.
In tumble. There's nothing Popo can do. And now we got Sopo. Sopo versus Peach.
Downhill battle.
Yeah. And actually, even as far as Sopo goes, in a way, this is actually one of Sopo's worst because he can't really get hard punishes. You know, spaces and whatever. He can get a gimp or something. It's not reliable, but, you know, he can do it. Peach, no, you're going to have to grind it out, win neutral over and over and over again.
So difficult to do it against Peach. And right now, Downling.
Oh, well that, no, he didn't get the desync.
I think right now what he's looking for, he just needs something. He wants that one more stock at least. I think that's what Team Germany want right now.
Yeah, I think, yeah. So going for grabs at this point is probably, if that's his goal, I mean, okay, yeah, that's harsh. Nana's back. She had her jump. I thought she lost it. Good stuff to Nana.
Nana hanging in there. Gets the grab.
Get up attack. Clutch that. Get up attack from Nana. Wow! And that...
you'll see that from VA sometimes in tournament. He'll get a Stitch face or a beam sword, and he'll just get rid of it. He'll be like, I don't want it. I can do it without it.
Oh, really? But he does that. Now he's up. He doesn't need it. It's in a sense like. All right.
Neutral air shield.
Whoa, they're sending in one of the big heavy hitters right away. Reaper.
Reaper's coming in. I mean, that's the best. Like, that's a good counter pick right there.
Yeah, it is. But this is a matchup that Marth has to play very disciplined.
Yes.
And I'm uncertain how, because I don't know if you've seen Reaper play a lot, but I wouldn't call his play style disciplined. It's very much go crazy. And, you know, it's kind of like Kala W style, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah. Kala W, but with Marth. He just goes nuts and, you know, goes for non-guaranteed stuff, but mix up heavy to get in this opponent's head.
It's cool seeing a Marth like that, but at the same time, you know, this was the beginning. This was the start.
Yeah,
this is the incredible
poor
start.
Poor Nana.
Straight away.
I mean, that's so brutal. We were talking, oh my god, this matchup is so bad. Right away, down smash, 51%, Nana shield break.
Poor Nana.
Bam. I mean, look, he was at zero when that started. 50% and a shield broken Nana. Oh my god. Okay, no, it was there as well.
Down smash too good, people. Down smash too good.
Oh god, I saw such a... Leva putting his hands in the air. So happy about it. A Peach main. Okay.
Restarting the controller, maybe?
Well, yeah, I think so.
What I was going to say is, from what I know, VA has told me he does actually like this matchup.
It's not uncommon among Peaches, actually.
Yeah. It's like, if you play it right and you know what you're doing, this can be very difficult for the Marth. That's why.
Right. It's one of those matchups where to have an advantage, you have to play super disciplined. And, like, on most levels of play, I think it's pretty even, you know?
Yeah.
I love Reaper's use of Light Shield versus characters who are heavy on the shield pressure. Because he knows. Okay,
it didn't work that time.
Down smash too good, like we said. And wow, Reaper going ham with all of his crazy movement. He punishes the air dodge. That's fantastic. Ooh, bad DI. He was probably expecting
good forward air.
An up air there.
Yeah. Switched up a little bit.
Okay, Lance. Oh, I thought it was safe. Lightning quick grab. Good recovery, but nope.
VA making this recovery very difficult by throwing the turnips up in the air. Making Reaper think a little bit with his recovery.
Yeah, limiting his options.
Right now, three apiece.
It's looking like, right now it's kind of looking like VA is the monster.
Yeah.
The crew battle monster. Is this a thing he's known for in the UK?
Yeah, he should be. Yeah, he should
after
be.
This, he
after,
will be.
After today.
Yeah. After tomorrow, above all.
Oh.
Almost made that combat versus Bane.
Yeah, he manages to get out. Dangerous situation there.
Yep. And
Reaper following up. Reaper's like, he's not getting a good foothold in this match right now. Like
He's just kind of... He's jumping around trying to bait VA into falling, you know, into trying to go for an early unsafe punish.
Yep.
But he's... V is just not running into it. He's playing it. He's waiting for when he knows he's gonna get a hit. Oh wow! The ECB pushed him off. I can't believe that.
I didn't expect that to happen. Right now. Forward smash. Oh, that was an early death from a non-tip forward smash.
Yeah. And okay, maybe get something going.
Right, Reaper gets something.
Is it? Oh, brilliant spacing
nice there.
Some great air footsies. Fourth throw.
Gets another one.
Dash.
All right. Down. So this is where. Another stitch.
Oh, okay. He throws it away. Does the VA, I guess. Ooh. Oh, nice recovery.
Jeez.
Oh, wow.
Now that is spacing.
Yeah.
Spacing at its finest right there.
Goes right through the turnip as well. That's so smart. People forget that with, you know, turnips and many of the projectiles. You can just hit, well,
just
straight
hit
through.
Away. Ooh, misses the sweet spot.
Yep.
Gets forward head for it nicely.
Oh, wow. Up smash. Probably accidental, but it worked out. Oh, nice dash stacks.
77%.
Oh, surprise grab. Very nice. Holds in so he gets shield poke.
Reaper has to be careful.
Yeah, will he go? Yeah, he goes high. But he gets back down.
Up tilt?
Yep.
All right, he's at 114%. That makes it difficult for Marth to kill.
Yeah, it's true. He has difficulty killing in this matchup in general.
Yes.
He's usually going to have to expect Peach to go high, you know, get high. Oh my god, what a brilliant tech! But he takes it.
He takes it anyway.
Wow.
Good tech. VA holding it down for England right there.
Yeah, 7 stocks. I mean, that's a big early lead.
Yeah, it's a good lead.
I mean, but again, like Reaper, since he is one of those crazy, crazy players, he's one of those that can get momentum going. I think he's really good in Cruise.
That's true.
For you know, because of the style.
Rush down Marth.
Yeah. Rush down Marth, get the crowd hype Marth.
Yep. It's different. Yeah. I feel like a lot of the European Marths are like that, though. Like a little bit rush downy.
Yeah, it's true.
Like, Salpat doesn't play like a lot of Marths that I watch.
Yeah,
like, he's quality.
Oh god, I haven't played him since Beast 1. I have to play him.
I always try, and every time I see that guy, I'm like, we're getting some friendlies in. You're gonna send me some nasty stuff right now.
Oh yeah, he's amazing. He's amazing.
Quality guy.
Yeah.
Team England thinking hard. Reaper has one life, so this is a big decision right here.
Right.
Because if you can come in, take that life, take that stock without losing any, you are up. You are up a good, how many stocks? What, good 4 stocks?
Yeah, yeah.
That is a big lead.
An entire person, that's a big lead. And also, they're going to have to pick somebody who's not going to get counterpicked too hard. And it looks like Fuzziness.
I'm surprised that they're sending in Fuzzy. I have a feeling that that decision was based maybe to do with nerves for a little bit. Because I feel like we have 2 Sheik players who I know feel comfortable against Marth.
Oh, right. Okay,
but
I see.
They're definitely not on the same level as Reaper.
Right.
But you would think they'd still be able to take one stock.
Yeah, I think Beer Terrell gets on the...
Yes.
Yeah, I think... Well, I mean, I trust the crew as well. So, I mean, they probably have...
Between
have
them,
plan.
They have a plan. They'll know what they're doing. So yeah. They've sent in Fuzzy. Did we see that Fuzzy? He's gone Fox. That means he's playing serious.
All right.
He's been serious.
He's been playing. I thought he had switched completely back to Falcon.
I
know he doesn't play a lot.
I
know he's barely a smasher anymore. Or he is a smasher, but he doesn't compete that much anymore. I know that. But I thought that because of that, he was like, yeah, I'll just play Falcon. But, hey, man.
He kind of switches in between. It's like he'll play Falcon until he loses, and then he'll be like, all right, Fox.
Do you know what he played? He played Falcon at Evo 2013, right?
When
he got 17th or what it was?
Yeah, I think that's right. Yeah, I think he was playing Falcon at that time.
Yeah.
Right now, he's looking good.
Ooh.
Oh. Catches the wrong hit.
Okay, this could be big. Nope. Misses a read there. He tried to cover tech in place and take away. But Fuzziness wisely takes it.
Reaper a little bit on the edge right now.
Yep.
Fuzziness looking for the edge guard, gets it.
Good.
Sneaks
very
in that
good.
Back air.
Yep.
So quick.
Yeah, that was really quick. I was kind of, I don't know. I've seen Reaper mainly versus Fox, and he can really put in some work on Fox. I think that's one of his best matchups. So I was a little bit like, this is a bit of a risk, you know?
True.
Sending in Fuzzy, but Fuzzy made quick work of him.
Yeah, it's only one stock, and you need to have that mindset and all the big guns.
They're big guns. They're sending in ice. Wow. I'm actually a little bit surprised considering Prof is still on the team.
Yeah. I think maybe they're trying to... I think what they're going to do... I think the idea for Team Germany right now is send in ice, deal with Fuzz, lure Prof out.
Right, right.
And see how much he can do. Because, I mean, ice is phenomenal. We all know that.
Oh, he's playing Sheik. Oh,
and he's going
Sheik.
So he's being super serious.
Okay, let me tell you something. The only... Sheik ever to fully optimize PAL tech chasing is ice. He's the only one who can really, really do it in this version. It's so much harder.
I always say
that the hardest punish game in the game is Sheik's tech chase in PAL if you're going to do everything on reaction.
Yeah.
It's really hard.
It is very difficult.
You have to mix up with whether you wave dash or whether you walk forward, depending on so many factors, how they the percent, how much they DI, if they DI straight away, if they DI down and away. It's crazy. But here we're going straight in, and wow, Fuzziness just runs into that grab.
I think right now Fuzziness, he needs to play as solid as possible and see what he can do here.
Yeah. I mean, obviously, Germany is hoping for this to be a blowout. That's how they're going to win this crew battle.
Yep.
Ooh, tick back.
Ooh, ooh, the pressure.
And, nope, Fuzziness always kind of enigmatic. He never really shows up, and whenever he does, he proves himself, man.
I'll tell you what. Ooh,
ooh, wow.
I'll tell you, in my history of the UK smashing, I'll tell you, Fuzziness never turns it up as much as he does when the crowd is behind him.
Oh, really?
He wow. always turns up.
That ooh, makes him good at internationals. Oh, that's a shame. But oh well.
It's all right. We'll keep it on the positive side. He has taken a stock.
Yeah, like, he has taken a stock. That's super important off ice.
And that's what they need to do right now. But ice...
gets a grab. Will he get a punish? Ooh. Smart take in. That was to avoid, you know, the second hit of Falfair. That's definitely why Ice did that. And he succeeded.
Ooh, that was
and
nice.
He gets... and that's... yeah, that's it.
So
that's
nice.
It. Yeah. Such a nice Sheik, man. I'm still salty that I switched. I wish he would have stuck to Sheik. Oh my god. Oh, wow.
See right there, people? That's why sometimes you just gotta hold that ledge.
Yep.
Just hold that ledge.
You can't get too antsy. So many of the recovery tricks that people do are dependent on people getting antsy at the edge.
Yeah.
Huge part of the game. Okay, some stalling, but he does the mistake and...
oh, he managed to get it.
Very nice. Good read by Fuzziness that it was a regular get up or the get up attack.
Yeah. I didn't think he was going to get the up air. I thought it was a bit too slow.
Ice actually jumped into it.
Oh, I didn't see that.
That's easy to do, especially if you're expecting a back air or a neutral air and you're trying to DI. And ooh, went for the reverse forward air. Doesn't get it. Nice, good reactions.
Oh, wow. That was for the crowd.
That was for the crowd. Absolutely. Oh.
Oh.
Did you see that Wade? Genius. Oh, off.
Oh.
Missed the fastball, and he's going to get hit.
He gets
by
away
that.
With it, though.
Yeah.
He's down smashes. Oh, neutral. Yeah. He's done it. Oh, he misses it.
Oh wow. That's so important. Wow. Look at Fuzzy smiling, man.
That is so important.
The UK crowd, UK and Norway, they are the most crazy crowds.
Oh, wow.
In Europe. Weak back here.
Very nice short.
Okay.
Freeze the roll.
I think he was kind of looking for some cheese there at the edge. And I think he wanted a back throw hard with shine.
Yep. That was well thought out by Fuzzy, though. Very well thought out.
Oh, here we have it.
Woo.
Bam, and... wow. That was just... even with that DI, that was just barely, you know, percentage-wise for that to work.
Yeah.
And it would have died anyway. So, yeah, it was for the crowd.
It was so good. It was definitely for the crowd. That's what I love about Ice's Sheik. That's why I miss his Sheik. His Sheik pulls off them combos.
Yeah.
That stuff you like to see.
Yeah. Beast 4, his take chases on Mango. Wow. He played like Plop in this version, you know, it was crazy.
All right. They sent in Professor Pro.
Expected pick.
Definitely.
Expected pick.
Exactly what we thought would happen. It has happened.
Yep.
The question is, how many stocks can Ice take?
Right. This could be the deciding factor. If Ice somehow goes crazy and takes 3 stocks, you know, then Germany will most likely win. They're at a huge advantage. Ooh.
That's how much.
There. Get stuck in the shine because it's not stale. Decreases the hit lag.
I want to see. Prof is playing very patient.
Yeah, that's very good.
But he is still trying to get in. I kind of want to see more lasers. I want to see more guns. I want to see more pew pew.
Ooh.
And there goes
very
one.
Nice. Very nice. That covered everything in that situation. Light shield. Okay, well this will hit. It won't kill. Pretty close though.
Pokemon just a little bit too small. A little bit too low.
God, I love his movement. It's amazing.
Oh my god,
did you see that? He got that on reaction.
That's so good.
Insane. You don't understand. Nobody knows how hard that is. It's crazy. Please, Ice, go back.
We missed you, guys.
We missed it so much.
Alright, big back air. Is he going to make the recovery with Zelda?
No, he just uses it to get some extra distance. Very smart. Ooh, and misses it.
He wanted that up tilt.
Yeah,
He was like, I could turn around and up smash, but I want an up tilt, and he pays for it.
You can also just take the edge, and Prof takes it. That was good. I mean, that's exactly what he needed. He lost one stock, but hey, man, so what?
Exactly.
UK is still up, and their best players are gone. They have Slim Shady, and then one more left. Yeah.
They're sending in the Mario. And you know if Slim Shady gets past Prof right now, they're going to send in Jelly. It's going to happen.
Yeah.
You know it's going to happen. The question is, can Slim Shady do it?
Yeah, that's the big, big question. I don't know. How do the... It's counter-pick stage, right?
Yes.
Yeah, so he should pick FD. Please pick FD.
Do you think they get one ban? I think they might get one ban, you know.
Oh, right.
Yeah. That's but true. I'll tell you what. Prof doesn't mind being on a stage where he can get chained right.
All right.
He really doesn't mind it.
That's the sign of a true high-level player, because... Like, when you play versus the really high-level players, you really gotta be in the mindset, if I get touched, I'm dead.
Yeah.
That's how it works at the top level most of the time, anyway.
Yeah.
It's like, you get grabbed by a top player, it's like being grabbed by an ice climber. It's not quite as bad, but almost, you know?
Almost as bad.
So...
I mean, once you get to top-level players, like, half the time is once you get hit, you know you're gonna take quite a bit of damage.
Yeah, don't get hit.
But I don't know. All right, so we've gone FOD.
All right. Okay, I don't know Mario because I'm not Slim Shady and I'm not Jelly, so I don't know.
I don't know much about Mario.
But hey, man, if Slim Shady believes in this stage, in this matchup, he probably knows something we don't.
He definitely knows something we don't, I'll tell you that.
Oh, very nice. It's very fast. He's very good at timing. Like, oh, my God.
That was nice.
Oh, had he gotten that, that's a shame. Quick neutral air out of shield. Slim Shady doing great right off the bat.
All right. That trick that we saw Jelly using, the wave dash back forward smash, I don't think it's going to be as useful.
Yeah, right. Oh, my God. And he gets it. Oh, my God.
Cape?
That cape was actually really good. The first one he did to cover the 4B.
Yeah.
National 4B. Okay, goes really high because he saw that Prof grab the edge, and he gets the neutral air. And...
Slim Shady
taking the first stock.
Jeez, press one if you're hyped for Mario right now.
Yeah. Oh my God, this could be... If he does this, I mean, then Germany could win. He could be the carrier of the UK team, okay? Ooh. Again, we talked about the before on stream, the down air is such high priority. It's crazy, actually. Very few characters have a move that is out for a long time and has much priority downwards. It's like Falco, pretty much. Most of the time, but Mario and Doc as well. It's a multi-hit move, but you know it's out almost all the time.
It's out for a very long time. And it's such an annoying move to get hit by.
Yeah, like, yeah.
It's such an annoying move. Both of these players, like just going back and forth right now. Like they're both being very aggressive, getting in each other's faces.
Yep.
Guess that grab.
Oh.
Attack goes.
He almost had that pick chase, man.
Oh, big nice. Down smash.
Damn, right. Now the German crowd is getting hyped.
Slim
man.
Shady putting in work right now.
Yeah, this is looking bad. Oh my God, a Samsung grab.
No.
Okay. Yep, he's being careful. Very good by Prof not running into the down air. I mean, you want the up air so badly at that point, so resisting the temptation is actually pretty difficult.
Ooh, there's the first wave dash back forward smash.
Oh!
Prof having a bit of trouble right here.
Yeah.
Slim Shady playing out of his mind.
Oh my God, really? Oh! I was like, if the cape would have come, if he had run forward and done the cape way out there, that would have been it, man. Wow, he grabs edge from that. It goes so high, and okay, it takes another stock.
He's living.
Oh, no, he doesn't. He's living. Oh, my God. Will he survive this?
Celebration.
Oh,
I guess the edge guard anyway.
That's super important.
The crowd, the relief from the crowd.
Yeah. And Kemp.
Ooh, there is again.
I think that's it. Yeah, that's it.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Slim Shady.
Slim Shady.
Please send it, Jelly. It would be amazing. But I think that the UK wants to win way too badly
no,
now.
No.
To send it. Oh, no,
I'm telling
they
you.
Don't care.
Oh, wait.
Okay, no, they're still discussing.
They don't know.
I think Jelly really badly wants to go in, but
of course he does. He's got more than just UK pride on his on the agenda.
Right. There's a lot of pride into this match. Mm-hmm. Europe's best Mario.
Mario? Yeah. Probably.
Yeah. Which of them is it?
All I'm saying right now is I'm looking over at the England crew, and facial expressions are not filling me with confidence on some of these players.
Yeah. Okay. They sent in BR Tarog.
BR Tarog. Okay. Take Jason right. Reaction right here, people.
Yeah.
Slim Shady doing the work for Germany right there.
Yep. So, do you know if BR Tarog is confident in this matchup? Is he good?
No idea, to be honest.
I would guess that he does. I mean, considering the fact that they sent him in.
Yeah.
So.
He's got to be at least a little bit confident. Got to be.
Yeah. But I feel like this is one of those matchups, you really got to know it. You just can't. Some matchups work in the way where it's, if your character wins, you just kind of win.
You just
go ham and you do what you usually do and you win. Yeah. But versus a character like Mario, I don't feel like it works like that. Especially not with Sheik.
No. I think in his mind, he'll be thinking, my character's better. If I just play this game correctly,
right,
I'm going to win. And that's all I need to do. Right now, I just need to go and take these three stocks and just do my best. And that's all you can hope for right now.
Yep.
Both these players.
All right.
Who do you think... Wait, so how many stocks? Is this five? Wait, how many stocks are left? Slim Shady has three?
Yeah, Slim Shady has... So it should be 7-8?
Six to eight.
6-8? Oh, okay. Yeah, Slim Shady lost two.
Oh, he lost two. All right, okay.
It didn't feel that way, so...
Yeah, he was playing out of his skin.
Yeah, that was amazing. Really impressed. So happy to see a skilled Mario.
These hand warmers.
Yeah.
These mid-crew hand warmers. What
is
this?
Come on, man. Come
what
on.
What is this?
This is like... People complain about hand warmers usually mid-crew. Come on, guys.
We like the flow.
What? What's up?
Big wave by R23.
Yep. One of the TOs here. Big shout outs to him. Making this happen.
Very
paying the salary of pro players and streamers everywhere. Yep. That's honestly what being a TO is.
He Amazing. Loves it. He does enjoy being a TO. All right, here we go.
All right.
I literally don't know anything about
the grab.
This
okay. I don't know about the follow-ups. It probably works like Peachy. Oh my god. Oh yeah. Mario has a chain grab and the up smash and the tomahawk grab. Doesn't
mini Ganondorf right here.
Yeah. For sure, man.
Yeah. Going for these forward airs and all sorts.
Okay, going for early dash attacks. Now the damage is at a point where a dash attack will knock over and lead to a combo. Mistimes the attempted punch right there. Slim Shady, crouch castle. That's really important. Snipes him. And now, damn. He had the right place. He just, wow.
Gets him that time.
Wow, I think Slim Shady is looking like...
He's feeling comfortable. He's feeling confident.
He's looking great, man. I'm impressed.
You know you're feeling confident when you do the simple things right, you know?
Yeah,
and he just
true.
Let him come onto the stage, forward smashed him in the face.
Yep. Oh, very nice with the down smash.
Especially to get this edge guard. He's got it.
He's got it. BR Tarog is a player who wants to play the game optimally.
Yeah.
That's why I feel like if he gets some experience in a matchup like this, he can really do extremely well. Okay, gets a grab. Will it lead to anything?
Nope.
I tried to go for the dash attack, I think.
Right now, both players are
playing careful. Oh, okay. It was a 50-50 there. He went for the... Bear Tarol went for the fade back. I think that was a flubbed up air. I'm almost entirely sure. Oh, wow. Runs into a forward smash and just 11%. Wow.
I'll tell you, running into a forward smash by Mario like that can drain you so much.
Yeah, it feels terrible.
Good back air.
Yeah, I mean... They knew where you were going to approach, and they took a big risk, too. It's like, you got outplayed, son, you know? What are you going to do? Ooh, very nice. I'm impressed by that. Waiting for the down air.
BL Tower again, a bit more aggressive.
Oh. Yep.
And so Slim Shady turning on. Both of these players
down smash. Like
remembering what this is for right now.
Yeah. Very nice down smash. Beer Tyrell really knows which situations where it's really, really good. It can cover so many options.
Down smash.
Okay. Oh, almost. Hits him with up B. And back this back air.
This must be it.
If he gets this at edge guard. Oh, yeah, that's it. That's it.
No jump?
Nah. Yeah, no, he didn't have his jump.
All right.
Okay, Beer Tyrell, what's happening about that?
That was good. Who? All right. I don't know who they're going to throw in right now.
Yeah, this is going to be tough.
Who does Lyrics play?
I don't know. I know Pro Smasher Tim is Fox.
Icon. Oh, Captain Falcon. He plays Captain Falcon.
All right. Wow.
All right.
I didn't know about him.
I don't know.
I tend to know about the Falcon players, you know. But, yeah, Pro Smasher Tim and Norm are both spacey players. Blaze plays Peach. We'll see. Yeah, Blaze could be an idea if Dia to send in this. Okay.
Alright.
Oh, wow, look at
these
that.
Pieces on stream.
The venue is clapping for...
You know he's feeling confident. Alright.
That should be the new... That should be, you know, the next sub button... emote should be him, you know, going like with a pizza.
Someone's gonna make a gif of that, I'm telling you. It's gonna happen.
Yeah, that's the main gify cat of this entire tournament. Like, nice combos, no man.
Okay, I'll tell you something right now. If they send up Blaze, it is a good idea because I know Vincent or BL Tarog and he hates Peach and Jinx.
Oh,
he hates them with a passion. He hates those characters so much that someone challenged him to a £50 money match, a player who was definitely below his standards, but he would not accept it because it was Jinx.
Oh, wow. Wow, like, that's hardcore
it's
hate.
It's not happening.
That's hardcore hate right there.
But I think he's been practicing against Peach a little bit more, but I know it's not his favorite. But
yeah, it's a hard matchup in this version. It is
difficult.
Yeah, 6-4. 6-4 Peach. Armada usually says 6-4 Peach in PAL, 6-4 Sheik in NTSC.
That's a good split. That yeah. Makes complete sense. All right. 6-4. Blaze about to see if he can hold it down for Team Germany. Whereas over here...
Yeah, Blaze is the last hope.
The last hope for Team Germany. Or will they fall once again to England?
Yeah.
In the history of everything.
Once again, or?
World Cups, World Wars.
Oh, okay. Yeah, once again.
That's true.
Well, last World War, I'm pretty sure Winston Churchill was like, get out of here, Germany. Get out of here. All right. So, this is very interesting. If Blaze takes out two stocks from BR Tyrell, England has a huge, huge pool of players to counterpick with. They still have Deathgazer.
Still have Deathgazer. Still have is Unreal in the list? I don't remember. Anyways, right now we're gonna see how this goes. How much work
it gets.
BR Tyrell.
Yeah, very nice. Yeah, you sometimes have a dash attack guaranteed. Sometimes re-grab versus Peach with Sheik's down throw. Oh, very nice. Beer Tyrell looking pretty dominant right now, actually.
Yeah, he's feeling himself right now. He's feeling confident. He's like, I've been waiting to get on the setup. I haven't played a match yet for Team England, and now he's up there.
Yep.
He's about to do the business.
Oh, he hasn't played yet?
No.
Oh, great mash. Okay, I think... Oh, ooh. Nice. Oh, wow, look at that. Did you see that? Facial expression from BR Tyrell.
He's happy. He's ready. He knows he's got this. He knows he can take Blaze.
And I gotta say that his hate for Peach doesn't show right now, especially in his edge guarding. He doesn't overcommit. That's the most important thing about edge guarding Peach. Yeah. You have to wait. You have to be really, really patient. You can't fall for the little, you know, dash, you know, fade. Go back and forth fades and up and down fades. No, you can't jump into that stuff, man.
You gotta just wait out. and just be patient and hit. Right now, I think Blaze is a little bit flustered.
Yeah, yeah, he is.
You see it by his facial expression. Like he's trying to find a way in.
Yeah, he's ooh, wow.
He's
dash
attacks.
Oh, wow, great tech. Oh, wow, he got a punish off of that. That's great. Yeah, it looks like he started this matchup for sure. I really feel like he knows what he's doing.
Ooh, good try. Nice. Can he get this edge guard, though?
Okay. Oh, back throw. Oh, he thought he was going to go high.
Yeah. Once again. Can you just hit him off? Nope.
Oh.
Went for the down smash.
Yeah. Hey, the big problem was that he ran up like that.
Yep.
That was probably some kind of flub, I think. Maybe try to walk up a little bit forward, but wow. And this is looking really bad. He goes, oh, nice.
This ain't NTSC.
Okay, has to turn it. Used it to approach, very nice.
BL Tarik right now, he's very content to just try and stay in the middle of the stage. Like,
right.
He's just like, he wants that control. He doesn't want Peach getting in his face. He's just going to stick this leg out right now.
Right. Right. And it happens right there because, like, anything, almost anything was going to kill. Like, anything strong was going to kill. And will he get a follow-up? Nope. DI's down on the way and not straight away.
Okay, crouch counts went to the down smash.
Okay.
That was nice.
All right. Will he get this?
Can he rinse and repeat long enough?
Nope. Yeah. But those grabs, you usually see players like Armada going for, you know, run behind them, float cancel Nair instead to send them back out.
You have to be real quick.
Yeah.
You have to be real quick to do that.
Yeah. Oh my God, is. Yeah, I think that's it. Well, it's not it, and he's... No, yeah,
that's
it.
All right. Two stocks to four.
And they can send in anyone they want. So this is grim.
This could go anywhere. This could go either way. This is legit. Who can hold their nerve?
Right, that's true. Because like, if somebody like Deathgazer goes in, like... You can in melee, you can choke away stock so quickly. You can, I mean, it's enough that you press the wrong button, or like you hold forward and you press B.
It's true.
You die.
You're dead. Like, you're done for. I think Germany believe Deathgaze is coming in because right now Blaze is practicing against the Falco.
Oh right, it makes sense in a lot of ways. But Jelly is standing up. It looks like he wants to play.
I think Jelly definitely wants his way, and I think he wants to hold it down.
Yeah, I think he just wanted to play in the crew battle. I think that was like
that's true.
His main thing.
Oh, Unreal isn't on the crew battle list. I thought he was. If Unreal was on the crew battle list, I'd definitely think he would have been thrown in. But he's going Mario. Oh wait.
All right.
He is going Mario. So we're about to see Mario Peach.
Oh yeah, he's been. I heard that he's been, you know, switching a little bit to Fox and
all of today in singles. He's been Jelly was playing Fox.
Oh.
But okay. We go to the crew battle. And he's been playing Mario and Bowser. So
okay. Oh,
he went Bowser against
that
Frog.
That was the... Because we wondered, who were they going crazy with Bowser about? And everybody was like, oh, of course it's Eichelman.
Nope.
But then we heard it was somebody on the UK team. I was like, who?
It's Jelly.
Jelly?
Jelly loves
Does
him.
He have a Bowser? Or
He loves a little bit of Bowser, and it's all right.
Yeah.
It's all right.
Okay, so this is... I mean, like you said, this could go either way. One reason that this is questionable is that Blaze potentially has a lot of Mario experience.
I think that might have been one of the reasons Oh yeah, true. Sam Shady. What am I talking
about? But hey, man, this is the last battle, and almost got it.
Wait, go ahead.
There's not many frames where you can hit Mario out of that, because okay. Gonna happen. Oh, goes high. As he sees that was very
sees
smart.
It. Ooh. That was pixels away.
Yeah.
That was pixels away.
And yeah. Oh.
Jelly bringing the hype.
Yeah.
Jelly showing that England pride right there. I know the Tesco boys are sitting at home watching this. Loving it.
You mean UK players
yeah.
who are not here?
Yeah, part of his crew.
Yeah, they should be here, man. Five people away from beating the European record.
Five people.
Five people away.
It's mad.
And yeah, ooh. So it's their fault, basically.
Ooh, ooh, catches him with the neutral air. All right, now we're looking interesting.
Yeah.
Three stocks to two. Jelly needs the stock.
Oh, okay.
Oh, that was. Guess I'm a dance man.
Yeah.
And you hear the cheer. You hear the roar of the crowd.
Yep. Oh my God, this is honestly the worst chant in the world for somebody's mindset.
Yeah.
Because if you get in the mindset, oh, just one more stock, I have to hit him. No, that's not how you should be thinking. You and it's actually showing right now.
Yep. He rushed in a couple of times and he got punished for it.
Yep.
We want Jelly to play like Jelly right now. That's what we want. Because if Jelly plays like Jelly, it's calm, it's patient, and it's what you need against a Peach. That's the reason he got picked.
Oh my God. Oh, I see. But he's getting down smashed.
He's running
and
in there.
And potentially punished. Oh, that was actually, that could have been a lot of hits on that down smash.
Yes.
I think it's gone a little bit differently. So that was a really good choice, I agree.
I think right now Blaze is feeling stuff. He's like, you know what? We have Slim Shady. I know what to do right now.
Yeah, exactly. He could definitely take this, man. Ooh, it goes for a down smash.
Didn't get the punish.
No. Nope.
I think he was looking for that as well.
Yeah.
Worst transformation of all time.
Yeah, this. When I'm playing, you know, a match that is serious in any way, I just get angry when it changes to this. I'm like,
yeah.
Come on. It's weird we usually don't play Winner Stays, but we're playing Winner Stays on a TV.
And then this happens.
And this happens. Like, on non-Winner Stays, I'll just go in anyway, whatever, I don't care, you know.
Yeah.
But it was Winner Stays, so it was, oh!
God damn it. We need that 20XX
okay.
tournament
yeah.
edition.
Yeah, we do.
We need
do,
it now.
Actually. Jelly's playing a lot more patient now.
He's done that. He realized what he was doing wrong. He realized, you know what?
Yeah.
I have two stocks. He has one. I'm just
right.
going to chill. He's going to make a mistake.
Oh, my God. But
Blaze ain't making
no
mistakes.
Yo.
Gets hit with
gets
a
down
smash.
And I mean, any hit matters so much at this point because this is Blaze's last stock.
It's like
oh.
two, one Mario smash in the wrong DI right now.
Yeah. Oh, and they're screaming for Jelly, but a stitch face!
He's got stitch face,
stitch
game
face.
Changer.
Oh,
he wastes it.
Had he gotten that and picked it back up, man, things would have been dangerous for your boys, man.
Yep.
But okay, 125%.
I think Jelly's feeling it right now. I think he just knows. He just knows.
Yeah.
He knows he has this.
Yeah. I really like what he's doing, actually.
Ooh.
That he's staying back and throwing fireballs, because, like, that could make the difference. And that's it. And the
catches
UK
him
wins.
Slipping.
The UK wins.
Crowd goes crazy.
Wow. What? So the UK crowd is in grand finals?
This is going to grand finals right now.
Wow. That's nuts.
For so long, I think Team UK have been chatting that we could finish second or whatever. All right, maybe go for the big time. But all right, now the big boys are showing up. We're going for a short break. Guys, we are going for a short break again, about 5 minutes.
And
tell people, tweet it out,
yeah,
grab
some
snacks.
Tweet it out. This is the grand finals of the crew battle here in Europe to determine what the best country is. And I'm actually really surprised that and impressed that the UK got second. You're really happy about that. Of course you are, man.
All right, guys. Be back here. You don't want to miss this.
No, you do not. You do not.
Decide to challenge the best without a cause. Destroying the competition without a flaw. Training from day to day like it's a job. Heading straight to the winner's bracket without withdrawal. How many of us traveled here with no regrets? Pick your opponent, this is the very last test. Pick the winning decision. go for broke without those precisions. I'm ready to fight until my last breath. The fighter's perception, this is the missing tech. I studied the rules, I'm choosing no regrets. And living my dreams without the hidden bets. I take my fist to the sky. Top 16 dreams until we try. Put my hands on that champion belt. And leave the ring the winner or nothing less. Come on. And fight with the best of the land. And battle with the beast from Japan. Get liver with the fans in the stands. More viewers in the stream yet again. Coast to coast, we are warriors that land. Final blows, tech blows once again. CEO, battlegrounds are at hand. Fighting with the warriors yet again.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls and fighting game lovers from every nation, we bring you the most sensational fighting game tournament of the year, CEO 2015!
Get my hand, my equilibrium right. Every sound tuned out when the high piece shots, when the salties run in their mouth. Never thought I could roll with the best. Never thought I could hone this dress. Now my theme song come when I step on stage. Brr, 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 brr. And it feel weird rage, cause the beast at the cage now. Sweet reason I got light play style. Free to play like guns, no case style. Only blind in my way, cause the one that I play last. Wanna get off me, but I will pass. Any fool trying to money match me, gonna leave with less cash than they came with. Y'all know what my name is. Y'all don't know I'm already famous.
With the best of the land. They battle with the beast from Japan. Get liver with the fans in the stands. More viewers in the stream yet again. Coast to coast, we are warriors that land. Final blows, tech throws once again. CEO, battlegrounds are at hand. Fighting with the warriors yet again.
What is up, guys?
Yo, yo, yo!
Grand finals of Cruise here at Here 2, the second biggest event in Europe of all time, and I think it was on the top 10 list of biggest of
top all. Top 10 in the biggest Smash tournament.
Yeah, it was number 10
all time.
That's crazy. I'm so happy about that.
Out here in the UK. Shout outs to Team Air for putting this on.
Oh, yeah. It's amazing. Big thanks and shout outs to them.
And the brilliant thing is, this might be the second day. It's International Cruise Grand Finals. And we're just getting started, people.
Yeah, yeah.
We're just getting started.
Tomorrow is the big day. Brackets.
Big bracket coming up tomorrow. Cruise going on here. All right. Sweden, England, uphill battle.
Yeah.
Sweden definitely the dominating force in Europe. But Team England about to hold it down. Dude. I can see Prof. Prof is looking confident. Prof is looking hella confident. I like this. All right, I like this casino thing right here going on by Geeky Goon Squad. I like this. I don't like that it's 91-9 versus England, though. I saw the last one. The last one was, what, 2080? And what happened? How many of you lost your coins?
A lot of people lost.